Hello everyone, welcome to worship. In view of the current lockdown restrictions in England, we're back to having worship from people's homes again, recorded for each Sunday. And at Yarm, we're going to do our best for as long as we can to keep offering these services in this way. This is the worship for Sunday, the 8th of November, which is Remembrance Sunday. Normally, it's an incredibly significant day in our nation where people gather together to express their gratitude and to reflect together on the sacrifice of so many people. This year, we are unable to come together in the way that we normally would, but we still come together to recognise the significance of this day and all that it means for so many people. Our worship today is mostly following an act of worship that's been prepared for us by churches together in Britain and Ireland. We hear from the Psalms. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. I lift my eyes up to the hills. From whence will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. We hear from the prophet in the book of Lamentations, who says this: "This I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning." And the prophet Isaiah encourages God's people, saying to them, "Those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint." The prophet Micah says to God's people, "What does the Lord require of you but to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God?" We're now going to sing the hymn, "Jesus Calls Us Here to Meet Him," as through word and song and prayer.
Jesus calls us here to meet him, as through word and song and prayer. We affirm God's promise, presence, where his people live and care. Praise the God who keeps his promise. Praise the Son
in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations. that all people may together live in freedom, justice, and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability, and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts, past and present, have been given and taken away.
They shall not grow old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn.
At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Let us keep silence. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Let us pray. Ever living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we sing the Remembrance hymn, O God, our help in ages past. And this is accompanied by the choir of King's College, Cambridge. Hear these words from the New Testament. John chapter 14 and verse 27. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. From the letter of James, chapter 3, and verses 17 to 18. The wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And a harvest of righteousness is sown in peace for those who make peace. And from the first letter of John, chapter 1 and verse 5. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you, falsely, on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. And now we sing the hymn, Father, I place into your hands the things I cannot do. Father, I place into your hands the times that I've been through. Father, I place into your hands the way that I should go, for I know I always can trust you.
To
Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict, for all who suffer because of the impact of coronavirus, for all who work hard to bring relief. We pray that God may give us peace. For the servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God, may God give peace. God, give peace. For those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss, may God give peace. God, give peace. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return, may God give peace. God, give peace. For civilian women, children and men, whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatreds of humanity, may God give peace. God, give peace. For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free, may God give peace. God, give peace. For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for peace and reconciliation. May God give peace. God, give peace. For those suffering from illness and those who feel isolated, lost and alone, those who are suffering despair, and those who find it difficult to see any hope, may God give peace. God, give peace. For those worried about their livelihoods and those who are becoming desperate, for those who work for charities and agencies which seek to offer advice and practical support, may God give peace. God, give peace. For those who teach our children and young people, those who work in the NHS and in the health services of the world, all those on the front line and all those who support, may God give peace. God, give peace. For peace, equality and justice, within and between nations, and for wisdom and humility amongst those who lead. May God give peace. God, give peace. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish, and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world, and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. Let's all join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We will now sing, Calm me, Lord, as you calmed the storm. Still me, Lord, keep me from harm. Share together in the act of commitment. Let us commit ourselves to responsible, loving, and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace?
We will.
Will you seek to heal the wounds of war?
We will.
Will you work for a just future for all humanity?
We will.
Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all people and live lives of justice, courage, and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen. So a blessing. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you all and remain with you always. Amen.